And yeah, so we looked at even the rook pawns last time, right? What are the key squares? The concept of key squares. What is the concept of key squares? And key squares will allow you to know if there is only a pawn left and there is no other side does not have a pawn. If you only have a pawn and the other side does not have a pawn, then you know which are the key squares so that you can win. I mean, if you reach the key squares, then you can win. And we looked at it for all types of pawns, and specifically rook pawns. Specifically, we looked at, right? Rook pawns. It will be like g7, g8, or b7, b8 for white, or b1, b2, or g1, g2 for black. Okay, those are the only key squares. If you reach those key squares, and if you have a pawn, a rook pawn, then you will be able to queen it. Okay. Now we are going to look further. Now, what is the case if both sides have a pawn? Okay. Now, most of these end games, many of them get drawn because obviously it is equal material, right? But and as long as you don't make mistakes, and as long as your position is not too bad, then you can get a draw. But there are some special things that you need to be aware. So let us look at the first case. Is that if the pawns are blocked, so this is the case where it is highly likely that it will become a draw. Okay, because both pawns are blocked. Okay, they are on the same file and they are blocked. Now each king will try to defend his own pawn and try to attack the opponent's pawn and win as much as possible. Right now, most of the time it is not possible, but there are sometimes it is possible. Okay, so what happens is in this end games, there is a concept called as critical square. Okay,
now, and white has more activity.
Sorry,
white has more king activities.
Yeah, white has got more activity here, but it all depends. So let us see. First, let us see what is the concept of critical square, and then we will see. See, critical square is one that, if reached by the attacking king, can force the capture of the enemy pawn. Okay. So now, currently, I have shown it in this diagram, the critical square from white side. Okay. From white side, because white has got an advanced pawn on g5, black has got a pawn on g6. Okay. From white side, the critical squares are f6, e6, d6, and d7. Can you see how they are marked? Okay, so three squares next to the pawn, one square ahead. So your pawn is on g5, so it is attacking f6. So it is f6, e6, d6, and d7. Okay, if any of these squares, white king lands on any of these squares, then he will be able to force black to give up the pawn. Okay. Similarly, from black side. Now, blacks, can you tell me what are the critical squares for black here? Black's pawn is on g6. So, can you tell me what will be the corresponding critical squares from black side?
d5, e5, f5, and f4.
Yeah, so it will be, first of all, g6 is attacking f5.
f5,
e5, d5, and d4. Okay, those will be the squares that if occupied by the black king, then he will be able to win the white pawn. Okay, so why it is like this, we will see both these positions. We'll see it. One is on king is on e7 and e4. Okay, so let us try to put this. Have you seen this video that I had tools, clear board?
Oh, there's an L1 final going on. Cool.
So, and black king is on e7, white king is on e4. Okay. Okay. Now, if you can look at it from both perspectives. If it is white to play, okay, what will happen? Let us look at it first. All right. White to play. Let me copy this position so that. Okay, I'll keep it. Okay, first is if white to play. White to play, I told you what are the critical squares. These are the critical squares, right? White will try to reach any of these critical squares.
So whichever side is to play wins.
Sorry?
whichever side is to play.
Yeah, with. Whichever way side to side with. But it is from white perspective, he has to reach these squares, right? He has to reach these squares. So let us see what should white do? White should try to
King e5.
King e5, correct. Right? Forced to think. And now black has to give up the opposition. So whichever way black goes now.
King f7.
Yeah, King f7.
King f7.
Now King d6.
King d6. King d6, right? Now white has reached
d7.
The square. So now
King g7.
Then King
e7.
E7.
Yeah. Now.
Now King
h7. H7, then King f7.
King f7.
And now
King
now the king will have to move and the black pawn will fall.
Correct. So now the black pawn has fallen and there is no way black can defend it once the king reaches the critical square. But can black defend this ending? Can it be a draw or a win?
I feel like it can be a win. Definitely a win.
Black will go to
it might be a draw.
Maximum chances might be a win.
Lot of noise. So I muted everybody. Okay. So now only chat. Okay, only chat. So just type it on the chat only. Okay. Now remember if it is a draw or a win. Vedant, you are saying a draw. Vihan, you are saying a draw. Can you remember what it was told last week when we looked at it? What were the key squares if the pawn is on fifth rank? Right? If the pawn has advanced to the fifth rank, then the one row ahead of the pawn is the key square and white is already on the key square. Right? Do you remember this? Don't forget this. That's what I'm asking, that this is all important. See? When we had looked at it, as long as the pawn is up to fourth rank, then it is two rows ahead. But the moment the pawn is on fifth rank, it is just one square ahead also is a critical square. So don't forget this. Okay. So the king has already reached the critical square. So no matter what now the easy way for win for white is just play king h6. Now black. Let us say black wants to get as much in the corner. Then this, black plays this, then g7, and now black is forced to give up. And white moves this, and then it's a win, right? Okay, so everyone got it? The moment the white king, because the pawn was on, remember, if all this thing is shifting one row down, if the pawn was on g4, king was on g5 and black king was on g7, then it would be a draw. Okay? Because then the black king is having the opposition and then he is not allowing the penetration to the key squares. If the pawn was on g4, then the key squares would have been g6, f6 and e6. And if the white king is not allowed to reach there, then it's a draw. Okay? Even though white is a pawn up, then it's still a draw. Okay? Cool. So now let us look at it. Now let us look at it from the black's perspective. Okay. But instead of white to play, let us say it, make it black to play. Okay. Now black's to play. What do you think is the position here? Black to play. Are you sure it's a draw or a win or it's a draw, you are saying, and why? Very, very important aspect. Okay. So just the black. Okay. Black is going to win the pawn now. Black playing here. Black is going to win the pawn. Why? Because black king will be able to reach the critical square. But will the game be a win for black or a thing? Let us look at it. Let us look at it very, very carefully. Okay. Okay. So tell me the moves for black. Sorry, white. I am playing black. Or okay, you play for white. King f5. Okay, king f5. So what is my critical square that I can reach now? black can reach his critical square. Which is the square? D5, correct. D5 is a critical square. So now the moment it has reached, black has reached D5, now theory says that now black is going to win the pawn now, no matter what white does. Okay, so what will white play? King F3, okay, king F3, then black king to E5. Now, king G4, correct? Because otherwise it is going to, and now king E4. Now, H4. Now, king F4. Okay. Now, H3. Okay. And white will, king will take the pawn. Now, G3. Correct. And now it's a draw. Why? Because the criticals, now key squares, now the critical squares is concept is gone. Now, because that is there only for winning the pawn when in case of a block pawns. Okay. Now there is no longer a pawn, white pawn. So now black has, now it is a battle about key squares. What are the key squares for the black pawn? Name them. Remember, pawn is, where is it? Is it advanced to the fifth rank or not yet? Name the key squares for the black pawn. No, name the squares, key squares. What are the key squares? H4, G4, correct. Pawn is on sixth rank. I mean, pawn is on, from black's perspective, it is two squares ahead of the, two rows ahead of the pawn. So which is H4, G4 and F4. Those are the key squares. Okay. But white has got the opposition. White has just played. So no matter what black plays now, black plays here, then white will block it. Black plays here, white will block it. Black plays here, white will get the opposition. And the moment you move, push the pawn, right? What happens is the key squares now are even one row, even further ahead, which is H3, G3 and F3. Black is just not going to reach those, right? Black is just not going to reach those. Black is just not going to reach those squares. So now the king is going to block it. Right? So there is no, so now this will become a draw. So there is a difference. Please understand, there is a difference between key squares and critical squares. Okay, it is very, very important to know this. Okay, so any doubts, any this? Is it clear? I'm freezing. Huh? I think there is some problem. There is some rain just starting and my network might be thing. If it is too bad, then I will switch my network to mobile. Okay. No, Archit, what I was saying is, see, which part you didn't understand. See, first thing is that, remember last week's thing is very, very important. Okay. It is about key squares. Key squares is for when you have only you have a pawn and opponent does not have a pawn, then you want to figure out whether you can win or not with your kings. Is only kings and pawn, right? Then you have to know these key squares, which is generally two squares ahead, two rows ahead. But, oh, is it? I'm freezing. Huh? Just 1 second. Then, okay. Then let me create the mobile hotspot and change it. Just 1 second. Let me switch the network. Is it better? Can you hear me now? Let me unmute. There is a lag still, huh? No, okay, fine. So okay. So it is better. I am on the mobile network now. Fine. So what I was saying is key squares will allow you, Archit, to know whether you are winning or not after you have got only a pawn left. Opponent does not have. And here critical squares are telling you when there are blocked pawns, whether you can win the opponent's pawn or not. Okay. Archit, got it? Okay. All right. Cool. So now that we are looking at endings where both sides have a pawn. So first we have looked at blocked pawns. Okay. King and pawn versus king and pawn, but the both pawns are blocked. Now, if the pawns are not blocked, then what happens? So we'll look at four examples. Okay. First thing is that when the pawns are not blocked, that means potentially each one of them can race and become a queen, right? One will not get killed, not necessarily it will get killed. But what happens if they are on adjacent files? If they are adjacent files, it's like F and G or E and F or D and E or B and C, right? When such a thing is there, adjacent files, it is even more chances that it will get a draw. Okay, as long as there is a defending king can reach and either for a opposition or for defense of his pawn. If he can reach it, then it is always a draw. Okay, now look at the first position here. There are adjacent pawns F and G. Okay. White is in a strong position because he is not only supporting his pawn, but he is also attacking black's pawn. Okay. But because the king, black king is nearby, say A, he is not nearby to protect his pawn, but he is nearby to kill the opponent's pawn. So what will black play? Black king will play E3. Okay. And then it is a draw. Why? Because I think I've got this wrong. King G4 will, I think I've got one notation wrong, but King E3, black to play King E3 is a draw, right? Everyone understands this. Okay. I am allowing you to unmute now. Okay. But please do it carefully. Please don't start talking at the same time. Okay. All right. So in this position, I hope you understand King E3 is a draw. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a question on the, in the last, when we were doing the critical squares.
Okay. Yeah.
What happens if it's black's turn to move?
In which position? The first one or the second one?
First one.
If it is black's to position, then that is what happens. Black plays king to e6 and then black wins the pawn. That is what comes in the second diagram what you have shown, right? Black's turn to move. Black will play king to e6 and then what you get is the second diagram with white to play. So white is going to lose the pawn, but not the game. Okay. Mm-hmm. White is going to lose the pawn, but hold the opposition and hence he is going to draw. Right?
Uh-huh.
That is what we saw here. See, it was the same position as the... See here, and it was black to play. Right? If you want to just see it how opposite... See, black to play plays king to e6 and then forces white to go win the pawn, but then the white king just gets in time to oppose. Right? And then it has become a draw. Right? Try it out yourself against the computer on Live Chess and then you will get it really well. Okay, fine. So now racing pawns. Okay, first position you have reached it. Let us look at the second position. Let us put it on the board. Okay, so again, what is this position? Again, white is in an advantage position, but black to play, whether black can defend. Can you first look at it? Look
yes,
at the
black
position.
Can defend.
Black can defend.
Black
did you count yeah. it properly? Just count the moves and see whether you can defend.
Yeah, I counted the moves.
Okay, so let us put it on the board and let us see.
Sorry, can't.
Let us see. Some people say he can defend, some people say he cannot. So let us see. King is on b5 and d4, and pawn is on f6 and g4. b5, d4, f6, g4. Okay, all right, let us put.
Oh, yeah. Wait, it can defend.
g4, f6, b5, and d4. And black to play. It is black to play. Okay.
Yeah.
So those who think black can defend,
King c6. Play,
I will king c6, huh? All right. King e4.
King d6.
King d6. King f5.
King e7.
King e7.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Defend.
So,
sir, if you
king e6.
Sir, the white pawn is the white pawn moving upwards or downwards?
You are in L3, so I will not. You have to tell me where is the pawn moving, upward or downward?
Upward. If you move it one step up, and then you will kill it, and then if the black kills it, it's gonna be a draw. And
yeah,
then
obvious, right? If the pawns come like this, then it will be a draw, right?
Yeah,
right. Black will be happy to give a draw. So now here, so it's a draw, right? This was a position where it became a draw, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let us just try playing some other these ones.
So why is your voice lagging?
You're freezing.
So your voice is lagging and you're freezing.
Yeah, looks like even the mobile network is having problem today.
We have to type it in the chat.
Okay, let me go back to my... I've got both networks, so... Okay, I've gone back to my broadband network. Is it okay? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? You can't hear me? No, I think that. No. I think it is. Yeah.
Try turning your video off.
Yeah, I guess so. I think I will best to stop video. And yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah,
we can hear you.
Okay. So. Yeah. All right. So you saw this. So this was an easy draw. Okay. Now let us look at some two tricky positions. Okay. Now if the pawns are not, see in both cases here, the pawns were on adjacent files. So here the key part was that even after white got some very advantageous position like this or even before, right? He could not do anything much because his pawn was on the adjacent file. So he could not push the pawn. Okay, so if he could push the pawn without exchanging, then it would be a complicated thing and you will have to calculate properly. In fact, he will get an advantage if the pawn was on, say, if the same pawn was on, say, some other file like H file, etc., white would probably have some advantage, chances of winning. Okay, though still black will try to. So let us look at such a position. What is such a position? Both pawns are far apart, but they are at the same level. Both of them are 3 steps away from queening.
But in this,
yeah,
like when white makes a queen, it's a little bit different case because white can give check and then the king has to move and then he can skewer the queen.
Yeah, but he cannot skewer.
I mean,
here he cannot skewer. Look at this position carefully. Look at it carefully. Position here. Okay, both white and black are 3 steps away from queening. What will be the case? Think about it.
Wait, I think white might be able to slow the pawn down from queening.
Yeah, and how it is, you know, what is the thing? Yeah, you are right, but it is a bit thing. Okay, so let us see. Pawn is on d4 and h5. Okay, and king is on c4 and f4. So c4, d4, f4, and h5. Let us put this position. So tools.
Sir, you are lagging because it's raining.
Yeah, I know. So
can I play white?
Yeah, you can play white. I'll give you white and I will play black. Black is on d4 and king is on c4 and white king is on f4. Right? And white to play.
Okay.
Okay, white to play. You play white.
h6.
h6. So
king e3.
King e3. What is the idea of king e3?
To stop the pawn.
Yeah. Okay, so king.
H7.
And
queen.
No, king e2. King e2. King e2.
King e2.
King c2.
Actually, no. It's a promotion with check.
Ah, yeah, you have to promotion with check, and then you have to stop
the
pawn.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah.
Because this now you have given a draw to me. Now it's a draw. The moment you played king e2, it became a draw. Right? So what you had to play was queen, but then king will come to c2 now.
Now it's easy because your king is close and you can easily win the pawn.
Ah, remember, see, everything is tied together. See, whatever
king
I'm
teaching. King h1. Queen h1.
Queen h1. Yeah. Queen h1 is not a correct move because the pawn will queen.
Queen c8 check. No, you have to do queen c8 check.
Yeah, what you need to do is you need to do several things. I think you are not exercising. Just give me 1 second. I want to make sure that my team is. Just give me 1 second that they are able to. Oops, sorry, that is not a thing. L1, sorry. Just give me 1 second. I just want to make sure that my team, there is a final tournament going on for this team and it is. Yeah, I hope they have started. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, they have started. So fine, then that is fine. And nobody is having any trouble. I just want to make sure. Morpheus L1. Okay, so nobody is having any trouble. Fine.
Can I just go back to the position? I just want to say.
Okay.
So when the queen promotes, when the pawn promotes into a queen, so when the king, after the king moves, can you go to d4 and then just
can you pawn? D4. D4. Pawn will still queen, right? I will still queen the pawn.
Uncle?
Yeah, this is No, I think you have all.
You H2?
H2, correct. H2 is correct. And then king to?
And then queen takes pawn.
Kill the pawn with the queen.
Yeah, so it was so simple and you are making mistakes in this. Then what will happen? See, you all kinds of means. People suggested queen A1, queen H1, queen D4, queen. Yeah, only thing that you had to do was pin the pawn because your king is already in contact with the black's pawn. Right? It is not even, forget about zone, out of zone, etc. All those things that I taught. It is not even that. King is all you have to do is for one move, you have to pin the pawn and then next move, you can win it. Right? So don't make mistakes like this. Okay? This should be you should never make a mistake in this. Okay? If the king was, white's king was further away, let us say if the king was on f4, okay? Then that also technique I have taught last time. Right, that you have to remember how to give the checks, make the black king go in front of the pawn, then gain a move, bring your king in one step closer, and then finally then win, right? We saw that in the zone, out of zone, etc., right? Okay, all right, excellent. So now let us look at one last position, okay, which is also something tricky and similar. So white is...
Can I play white again?
Yeah, we'll give a... We'll give it to somebody else. So black pawn on b5, king on c5, pawn on d5, white, and king on e4. Okay, all right, let's put this.
So can I play white pieces?
Yeah, who is that, Aditya?
I want to play this.
This was the skewer thingy that I was talking about. I thought it was this position.
Sir, if Vedant want to play, he can play.
Yeah, it is okay. We'll see. Who wants to... no, I think I gave whom... Whoever has got already a chance to play, please do not play. Somebody else. So, Aditya, you want to play? I'm okay. White to... You play white.
Can I play?
Or Arav. Any one of you.
Arav, do you want to play or I will play?
No, you play. Aditya, you play white.
Okay, sir. King e4 to e5.
King e4 to e5. Okay. All right. So, black plays. Black tries to promote the pawn.
Sir, pawn to d6.
Pawn to d6. Huh? Okay. Pawn to d6. Okay. So, what will happen? So, you are getting some idea. You are getting some idea. What? Okay. Let us go one by one. First, I will push the pawn. Then, obviously, you will push it. I will push it. You will become a queen. And I will become also a queen. Right? And then
queens.
Sir, what? Check.
Where?
Check. Sir, white may win if he plays carefully by giving check and check and check, where or it might white, go wild draw.
Where should white give a check? Here?
Sir, C8.
Okay. Now you are see. What is the key part you have to remember is these kings are in opposition to each other. So why
black king have to come front of the queen only.
Yeah. And then you can
kill the queen by pinning it.
Then you get a skewer. This is called as a skewer, like your barbecue. And you get to win the queen. Right? So this is the key idea. Yeah, this is the key idea in this end game. You have to see all these things. You have to see it is possible. Here, white. If you simply move it like this, then it is white wins, right? So what if black does not do like this? So what if black plays this, but when you move this, black plays his king, then
push the king up.
Yes, sir.
Push the king up.
Yeah, then again you still get an opposition, right?
But then
If black...
Yeah, white may win, but...
White pushes in front.
Black pushes the pawn.
Yeah, but what if black plays this now?
Then you then move your king.
King.
And then it will be a check giving by your queen, so your king might have to come in front.
Yeah, no matter what happens, black king is caught in the opposition. Right? This is anyway easy win for white.
Wait, but then
maybe
after
black won't be able to win because if white queens the pawn, then he can keep on giving check to the king.
And yeah, yeah, very easily. He will give the.
No, so after the, we promote to a queen and give check. No, like right now, like where we were right now. No, the other one that we were just doing.
Okay.
Yeah, no, and then we keep going forward, like where we played B. Where black played b2.
And no, then we first of all, it is white's turn to move now. So white, if white turns, plays d7, then?
Wait, but what happens if, can you go back a move? When the king goes up one more square without moving the other thing.
When? See, let us start from
Not here. When the pawn pushes.
Yeah.
And, pawn pushes, then the king, then the king goes up.
Black king goes up, huh?
Yeah.
Black king goes up, right?
So when we had that position, and what happens if
The king makes a double move all the way up.
Yeah.
And then after black pushes the pawn, what happens if he makes a double move?
So b3, double move means what? King goes up, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, then also black pawn will queen first.
So then white will lose.
Then actually it will be a draw. This will be a draw. How?
Because
I have to close the meeting. Okay. Let us join back. Let us join back on the thing with 3-minute delay. Okay, I'm going to end it right now. Okay, stop.